Hello and welcome to this channel. And if you are the first time here, subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button to see the latest technology videos. In this video, we are discussing about Java server pages. So taglib directive, example HTML, head title, sample JSP using a custom tag, title, head, body, H3, the date and time at the server are my tags, colon, date. An H3 body HTML. So in this example, the @ taglib directive indicates where to find the definition of the custom tag in the tag library direct descriptor or TLD file, and defines a namespace my tags for the tag names, and the string may be anything you like. So the JSP page engine recognizes my tags data as a custom tag invocation, and it calls the custom tag handler for that tag and replaces the tag and this body, if any, with the result. So JSP elements declaration. So declarations declare new data and function members in the scripting language for use within the JSP page. So the general syntax is Java declaration, JSP declaration, Java declaration. So a declaration must be a complete declarative statement according to the syntax of the scripting language used, and it is used to define variables and methods of instance scope. So variables defined in declarations may be accessed from multiple threads, so they must be thread safe. And declarations are initialized when the JSP page is initialized and are made available to other declarations, scriptlets and expressions. So declarations. So a page may declare optional initialization and cleanup routines. The JSP init method will be called before the page is asked to service any request, and the JSP container will call the JSP destroy method if it needs the page to release resources. So the signatures for these methods: public void JSP init, public void JSP destroy. Then JSP directive page import java.util.date, JSP declaration, private static string load time, new date to string, private static string get load time, return load time, then private static string get current time, return new date to string, JSP declaration, then HTML body, title, head, HTML head, title, hello world, JSP example, title, head, body, hello world, br, then this page was loaded into memory, get load time, br, the current time is get current time, body, html. So implicit objects. So there are a number of objects predefined by JSP architecture to provide access to the runtime environment, and the implicit objects are local to the generated JSP service method. Then scriptlets and expressions which affect the JSP service method have access to the implicit objects, but declarations which affect the generated class do not. So implicit objects are out, javax.servlet.jsp.jsp writer, request javax.servlet.http.http servlet request, response javax.servlet.http.http servlet response, then session javax.servlet.http.http session, page context javax.servlet.jsp.page context, config javax.servlet.servlet.config, page lava.lang.object, application javax.servlet.servlet.context, exception java.lang.throwable. So implicit objects. Out object. It is the object that writes into the output stream to the client. Request object. The object that requests triggering the execution of the JSP page. Response object. The instance that represents the server's response to the request. So the out object. So the out object is an instance of javax.servlet.jsp.jsp writer. And the JSP writer emulates java.io.printwriter but supports buffering like java.io.bufferedWriter. And the usual java.io.printWriter methods are available with the modification that jspWriter method throw .java.io.exception, and the buffer size can be adjusted via the buffer attribute of the page directive. So this was a brief discussion on Java server pages. We'll be discussing more on Java server pages in the upcoming videos. And if you are the first time here, subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button to see the latest technology videos. Thank you for watching this video. Bye for now.